Welcome to another Sims 4 speed build. This one was a challenge. Each room is a different size, so we have 1x1 all the way to 8x8. Needless to say, the floor plan was a little bit difficult. We are also joined, as you can see on the camera over here, dude, just hanging out on the couch back there. But yeah, so organizing this little puzzle piece was a struggle. At some point there was a hole in the middle of the build, and I didn't want to leave a hole like as a hallway to connect rooms. I wanted just all the rooms to be together, if that makes sense. And sadly I chose the wrong size room for one of the bathrooms. It's probably the saddest bathroom I've built in a while, and it has to be shared between two kids. The 1x1 is the only one I knew what I was going to do right off the bat. I'm going to do a built-in stackable washer and dryer. Those are my favorite things to do. It looks like it's built in. He put a little curtain in front of it. It's really cute. Unfortunately, it's in the kitchen, which I don't know if that would be the best spot for it. I don't know a lot of people who have a washer dryer in the kitchen, but now I'm thinking about it, there's usually, like at my friend's house, there's a hallway. That's where their washer dryer is. In my house, there is a separate entry to the outside, and that's where our washer dryer is and like our pantry and stuff. So kitchen adjacent. It is also hurricane day here in California. So I have the window next to me and I could see the rain. So far, it's not as bad as the media would lead you to believe that it is. We've had honestly worst rainstorms, but you know, I love the rain though. I love this weather. I like the speed build turned into weather talk. So we're just putting in all the doors. I did try to put a spandrel and some columns in this built-in washer dryer. I ended up removing them. I did not like the way they looked and went with the curtain instead. Under other circumstances, I think this would have worked if I used a different spandrel, if I had like a different design plan in mind. I really had no idea what I was doing at this point, except the blue washer and dryer had to be in a 1x1. And I don't know why I picked blue, but that turned into the whole theme for that kitchen is blue. So now we're doing windows. Windows are always so hard for me because a lot of the times they just don't match each other. And it's hard to find a nice set. Like, you'll get one from one pack that kind of matches with another pack, but the swatches don't always match. Even in the same pack, like I picked seasons for this one. Luckily, they all work together and are somewhat cohesive. But, you know, sometimes they're too big, they're too tall. Even the small windows, I hate these small windows, but I needed a small window for what I was thinking about in the kitchen and for the bathrooms. Always like putting a small window towards the top. Then we went, what are we doing? Wood floors in the dining room and the living room. That funky carpet is my favorite to put in kids' rooms or like a teen room, and just the weird colors. Parents' room, we went blue. And then we went for the blue tile in the kitchen. And I was trying to figure out if I wanted tile walls in the kitchen or painted walls in the kitchen. And you can see I am going through a lot of different tiles and trying to figure it out. I think I gave up at some point and just moved on to the other rooms and went back to it later because I just could not decide what I wanted to do. But the kids' room, I decided to match the pink in the carpet. And then I also decided to give them a teal wall and a purple wall because that matched the carpet too. So now they have two pink walls, a purple and a teal. Once I did that, I realized I knew what I was doing. I'm gonna put two kids in there. One's a girly girl, one's a tomboy. It's gonna work out. And it's just fun. It's a fun room. We went for blue in the parents' room and their bathroom. I think I did white in the shared kids' bathroom. And our pink dining room, because that just seems fun. And I kind of want to build another pink dining room. Oh, Oh, then I picked the blue swatch that I used in the dining room for the kitchen. It just looked really cute. There's really not a cohesive design in this house at all, except sometimes I used a pack to decorate a room. And I always miss a wall and paint the wrong wall and get like the wrong side or miss like one whole section. I do go back and fix it later. But I also have an issue with my controller. I play The Sims on PS4. I am stuck with it now. I have all the packs and everything. And my controller now has drift. And sometimes the joystick will get stuck or it won't let me click on things. And it bounces all over the place. I end up having to hit it to like reset it. So I ordered a new controller today. And of course, in my style, it's a RGB controller. So hopefully it'll be delivered soon and I won't have that issue anymore. And it'll be a fun, brightly colored thing to enjoy because RGB stuff makes me happy. I obviously have a lot of light up things. My chair lights up, the microphone lights up, my headphones, the lights behind me. What else? My headphone stand, my mouse pad, and my laptop lifter upper cooler fan thingy. Plus the laptop, actually. Everything lights up. It just makes me happy. So we went with, I believe it's the Seasons for the house. Yes. And here's another thing about matching swatches. The Seasons pattern with the cobblestones, they have the column that matches the cobblestones, but it doesn't match the paint swatches on the house. So I was like, why can't it just match for once? Anyways, ended up using the vampire flooring, the cobblestone flooring for the outside. I could see dude getting more comfortable in the background. He's so cute. Little old man there. It's kind of nice having him in the background so you could look at him and look at the speed build and listen to me all at the same time. I know he's very exciting to look at. He's adorable. So I did end up, I ended up putting a pool. It's a really small pool, and this backyard is more of a side yard. I guess it just kind of worked out that way. It is really tiny, and I know it's too, this house is very small for this lot, but it is what it is for a challenge. I'm in, what is it, Wittenberg? Because I do all my builds in that section usually, unless I'm doing like a theme with like the ranch would be in the ranch world that I don't remember the name of. Oh well. I do like the pack though. It is fun. Well, the horses are fun. It's interesting. Was it worth $39? Probably not. It didn't have to be an expansion pack. So now we're working on the kitchen. And I love that the ends, like the end pieces in this one, have that angle. It's so nice. It's just different. And I always forget that some of them have the angle and some of them have rounded end pieces. I do think they need more swatches for upper cabinets because a lot just look the same. And like you get the same dishes in each one, depending on which one you're using. And it would be nice to have some variety, at least a little bit. I always want to put that separate cooktop and oven, but I notice a lot of the times when I play with the separate ones like that, it glitches a lot and they can't cook in it because they, for, you know, Sims forget that something is in the oven and walk away. And then I can't figure it out because I don't know anything is in there. And I just gave up and just gave them the regular oven. We actually put a dishwasher in. I don't normally put dishwashers in. I used to all the time in like The Sims 3, and then I just kind of forgot about it. So we did some upper cabinets. That's why I wanted the small windows in here, so I could have upper cabinets. I honestly don't put a lot of upper cabinets in a lot of my builds. I've started doing it more. I just don't like the way they look a lot of the time. And then I ended up putting, this is when I put the curtain in front of the washer and realized I had to put the wall back to hang up the curtain and of course move objects on, and then it was a struggle trying to find the right curtain. I ended up going with the paranormal stuff pack curtain, the one with the little dangly beads. It's so fun. That whole pack is just beautiful. That and movie hangout stuff with the bright colors, so much fun. I ended up using paranormal pack for the entire living room, pretty much. I just put the pack on and was like, we're doing all the things, all the paranormal things. And then I decided we're gonna have a dog. So I got the bowl, and then I was like, let me get his little toy box out. Let me get a bed. We're gonna put a bed in the kids' room because the dog's gonna sleep with the kids, of course. I just thought it was a good idea. And I'll do that a lot, where I'll see a clutter item while I'm doing a different room and put it out and just kind of leave it there so I can do it later. Because, like, I will forget. Of course, get up with the laundry stuff on top of the washer and dryer. We did a couple of cluttery things in the kitchen. The rain just got louder. I don't know if you guys can hear it. I can hear it, and I have my headphones on. And my chair is squeaky, so I'm very sorry. But it's like rainy, but it's hot. It is muggy. It's muggy outside. I'm hot and I'm sweaty and I'm drinking coffee and it's been a tough day. So what am I doing? Oh yeah, this is when I figure out this bathroom is so sad and so tiny and I feel so bad for these kids that have to share it. I even tried putting a wall in to make it look like a built-in shower. Didn't work. So all of that work, and I ended up going right back to the same design that I had started with. I believe it is functional. I did not play test this particular build because it's really just a challenge thing. It is going to be up on the gallery. All my stuff is up there. I think my gallery name is Skafan13. I will double check that. But it'll be down in the description if you want to download any of my builds. There are some that I am proud of, like I did the Scooby Gang and their house, and I did Adam's Family and their house. I also did My Little Pony. I've done a lot of like themes, and I'm starting to redo some of the houses. I started with the Vampire World, so those will be on the channel pretty soon, of me redoing Vladdy Daddy's house and the Vators and the other two houses that are in there. I figured I wanted to redo the spooky stuff first, so I'll probably go to the Magic Realm next and go to Glimmerbook and do some of those houses and just do a whole witchy core vibes going on. So the parents' bathroom, they get the fancy corner tub. And then I did the built-in shower, where I just did the half wall and the glass half wall topper. You could also do it with a full wall and put the floor-to-ceiling windows in there and close it in if you wanted to and put one of the glass doors. It's fully functional. They can go in there, but it looks like a built-in shower. And you could do one with double shower heads too, which is nice. See, I did the thing again where I'm getting clutter for the bathroom and I'm like, oh, this would be cool in the kids' room. And that's when I decided, I was like, okay, this kids' room is going to be two. We're going to have bunk beds, and one's going to be a girly girl and one's going to be a tomboy. And my mind was made up at that moment. And I think it came out really cute. I like the kids' rooms. I liked doing kids and teens rooms, or like gamer rooms. I tried doing a gamer house once. It did not turn out well. I did not record it either. Didn't put it up anywhere. It's just me messing around. I'll probably try it again because now we have the cool gamer table that lights up, RGB stuff. The cool computer with like the camera on it, which is really nice. And like the neon and stuff. I think it would look good if I tried it again. At least have a gamer bedroom or office. I'll try doing one of those. I'll probably end up doing that today now that the idea is in my head. And then y'all will see it on the channel, hopefully. I don't do a whole gamer house. I don't know what the rest of the house would look like, though. Like, I don't know. Figure it out. I'll figure it out. We'll do something with it. Also, like, which aesthetic? Like, which pack for, like, a kitchen in a gamer house, you know? Like, would you want ultra-modern, you know? Or are they, like, a cottagecore gamer? I don't know. It's a kid's room. Obviously doing two different beds, two different colors. Parents' room, I believe I used Eco Lifestyle for most of their stuff. Only because the woods are going to match if you choose the pack for a bedroom. I do like, you know, matching different packs. Obviously, I use a lot of packs in my build. But I wanted the wood tones to match. And that's just the easiest way, usually. Unfortunately, there wasn't a desk in this pack. And then I really wanted to put like a love seat in front of the bed or like a bench, but the one in the pack was a little too big. But then I ended up finding this little table. I've never used this table before, but it fit so good at the foot of the bed and almost looked like it's built in, like it is supposed to be there. It just looks really cool. And it looks like one of those that you can almost slide up, like for like breakfast in bed type of moment. Is really nice. But I had to find a desk from another pack because I wanted them to have a desk in their bedroom, like their own little office. Because I didn't put one in the living room and I didn't have a separate room for an office. Though I guess I could have made the dining room an office. But luckily, these wood tones matched a little bit. So they get their little computer. I feel like every Sims house needs a computer. And this is when I found accent lighting for the kids. One got the soccer light, the other one got the cute little moon nightlight. And then each kid has a desk. But the ones that came in the, I think this is Happy Home decorator, didn't necessarily fit with what I wanted to do, but I ended up going anyways because the wood tones matched. I almost put that tent in, and I was like, no, we don't need that. We don't need that. It's fine. It's so hard finding a dresser, too, for a kid's room that matched the whole thing that was going on. But I did like the divider. I figured the divider and the mirror are really cute. With just like the stickers and the clothes hanging off of them. It really just fit. And then I was like, are they kids? Are they like tweens? I figured they're young kids. You know, but one is still just getting into like, that could be her play makeup, you know. And they do their homework under their little loft beds. I guess they're loft beds, not bunk beds. Bunk beds would be two beds, right? Then we just went, I like clutter. So they each got their little backpack going. Cloud light. I always do a cloud light. And I was like, girly accessories for the girly girl and tomboy accessories for the tomboy. These are my favorite lights too. The lights with the little pictures hanging off of them are so cute. And it works for any age range. It works in a kid's room, it works in a teen's room, it works in a parent's room or the living room or even the office. Like, I want to use it everywhere. And then you have to put the night lights in, otherwise you're going to get monsters. I don't know if you get, do you get monsters on bunk beds? On loft beds? That would be weird. Where does the monster, like, there's so much space under the bed. Right? I think we're doing dining room next. And I know there is a floating cabinet. I saw it a while ago. I do get rid of it at some point. But I think I must have just randomly placed it while I was building the upper cabinets. And it just kind of hung out there for a while. It's just there. And we did like country pink dining room. I don't know. Pink just felt like a good way to go for a dining room. And it's really simple. It's just the table and chairs and the little chandelier, the little country vibe going on in the dining room. Finding a rug was hard. I remember that. Rugs are always hard though. They're either too small or they're too big. And then if you size them up, some of them are ginormous and just like, it's ridiculous. I always like sizing them down too and using them as welcome mats or bathroom rugs. Those always work really well. Excuse me. And this is when I'm like, paranormal pack living room. Everything's paranormal. I love it so much. The furniture is just, it's so cute. It's, I want this furniture. I do want this furniture. Maybe not all of it, but most of it. And I think I use this TV stand, this trunk TV stand, a lot. I just think it's really cute. Just a cute idea. I want one of those in my life too. I don't know why I went with the dark plummy purpley maroon color, but it works. We just went with it. Everything is plum. And it actually looks really cozy with like the wall color and the flooring. It looks like a cozy living room. I really did try to use everything from this pack that I could. And it worked. It filled up the space nicely. Even the paintings were the right like size for everything I needed. And randomly, the dog bed still kind of blends in with everything, even though it's all maroon. It works. It still works. I also love that tray. There's some really cute trays, like in the clutter kit too, in the new kit too. There's like a sage tray and like there's a tea tray and then like the tray with the water on it that I think I used in the parents' room. So perfect. So we have an outdoor bar, because why not? No bar stools, because I did not like the way that they looked. So can't sit at the bar. You could sit at the picnic table that I put in. The outside was very much an afterthought, really, because I already was like, okay, we already have the inside, but I still wanted a yard. Doesn't really fit the challenge at all. It's just a backyard, side yard. But I wanted to make it functional for everybody. I ended up giving the yoga mat to the parents. They can do yoga in their bedroom. Why not? It fills up the space too. And wellness. And we got the telescope so you can get killed by a meteor outside. Why not? There's some activities so you can embroider or knit and paint. You got logic still going on. You got the guitar. So there's definitely skills in here. I think I've ended up putting a swing set in too because it filled in that back corner really well. Like, what am I looking for? Foosball table. Excuse me. Oh yeah, sports stuff. There is a bike tucked in. I don't think they can get to that bike. You could put it in your inventory though and get it out that way, but I figured the kid would just like stuff it right there. And you got the bucket is there for water balloon fights. Because you're by a pool, you know, you can have a water balloon fight, right? Makes sense. It's just a really cute swing set with the little flags and the flowers. I always follow up with do the basics in my rooms, do a little bit of clutter, and then at the end I go through the whole decoration categories and clutter everything up. Like the string lights in the kids' rooms I thought were really cute with the little skateboards. I think I find another art thing for the parents' room. Oh, and yeah, the bathroom thing for the kids' bathroom. Bathrooms are so Small bathrooms are so hard for me to decorate because the way my PlayStation and the camera is set up for me, which I think I can change it. If you put all the walls down, you can't put anything on the wall. So the wall has to be up, but then you have to get really close to it to be able to see where it is. And then like with snapping, and it's just trouble. It's trouble. I usually overclutter too. Because some of the clutter is just really cute. Like the dusty knickknacks. Like, it's adorable. Because it would be dusty just sitting on your shelf. You're not doing anything with it. Didn't realize that Pork statue was so huge. But it is. And there's my glasses that I have to put in every build. Your reading glasses. I always put one of the dirty mugs in there too. I always think that's cute to put it by the sink or put it in the office. Like literally, I have a mug right now, so you wouldn't just have a mug sitting there. More clutter. Clutter everywhere. And I figured because the yoga mat was in there already, I would give them the other little yoga mat and, like, the accessories. So. Landscaping. Not my favorite thing to do. I'm getting better at it. And I find myself doing the same kind of thing I always do. If there is a tree, I will put the grass underneath it, always. And some flowers every now and then, too, just to mix it up. I even did it under some of these ferns, too. I'm also very unorganized. Like, it's a hodgepodge of landscaping, or just like, that looks cute, I'll put it there. Except for like the bushes, obviously that's like their manicured part, but I figured this is just wild. But see, I've always put the grass around everything, even the tree that's not even on their yard. Here, have some grass under you. One day I should just do like a nice like English style garden where everything's in its proper place. There's like pathways and stuff. I think that'd be cute. But that is the build. It will be up on the gallery. Each room a different size. I think I go through the rooms. Maybe. Oh, I deleted all my notifications from playtesting another game I was doing. But yeah, this is the complete build. We got our front yard. There's a lot of empty space. So it'll fit on a smaller lot, obviously. And that's what it looks like. I hope you enjoyed watching. I hope you enjoyed the new version of me with my face doing speed builds. And I will see you in the next one.